Hello, this is going to be a look at all of the LEGO Series 4 collectible minifigures released in 2011. The first one on the collection sheet is this lawn gnome who comes with what looks like a very large fishing pole, but it's actually a smaller one. It's just a small figure to go with it. It's nice that the fishing pole came in the brown color here. The figure itself used the short child-sized legs to get it to be smaller overall, and the small or short beard, kind of the Santa-style beard, works out well for this figure because of its scale, makes it look like it's a much larger build just relative to the whole dude. With all that off, he has a very delightful and happy smile. Next up is the kimono girl, geisha style here. It's very nice printing on the torso and the exclusive slope piece that's used for the bottom of the dress here, and it came with the dark red molded but unprinted fan. The hair is the same hair piece as was used on the previous sumo wrestler, but here it actually gets printed. Very nice printing on the back of the torso here as well. Nothing else to be seen on the head itself, the actual headpiece, beyond just what you can see for the face here, but you do need a different angle to see the rest of the print on the hair piece, which is actually pretty nice as well. This swashbuckler has a little bit of classic styling with a somewhat simplistic print on the torso with the fleur-de-lis emblem there, and also fairly simple printing for the face. You know, they didn't put too much expression into it. Just makes it feel like this guy would fit in with some of the later original castle themed sets and figures as well. He has a foil there that's done in medium silver. No print to be seen on the back of this torso or head, of course, and got the little white plume in his large brimmed hat there. The punk rocker, they call this one, has a lot going for it. Really stands out from pretty much every other figure that LEGO has ever done. Lots of nice fine printing on the guitar there, or is it a bass? I think it's supposed to be a guitar. I like the print for the torso. I like the belt that's got the rivets going in it. And then, of course, the most standout feature here is the magenta molded mohawk piece. No print on the back of the torso. It's a little bit of a surprise that they put so much into this, but I guess they did so much already with the addition of the printed accessory piece. This one really stands out for me. The surfer girl can be used in the same scenes as the surfer guy they previously did, and this is another one with a nice printed accessory piece. A lot of the value of this figure, in my opinion, is right in that print right there. Two colors used for it, and nice fine striping where color was not used. No print to be seen on the back of this torso either, but again, it's all about the accessory in this case, and it's a nice, very useful face print as well. The Viking here is kind of a classic Hollywood Viking style. I like how much metallic print it has on it. Once again, another printed accessory piece, another entire figure highlight for me with the accessory. Lots of metallic printing with both silver and gold on the torso there. A little bit of printing on the legs, and nice texture actually for the main helmet piece. I don't like the gold, the pearl gold that's used for the horns there, but the texture of the helmet itself is nice. That's not just a paint speckle or splatter. That's actually a three-dimensional texture that's molded into that. And when you take this off, see just a little bit more of his facial hair and more clearly the scar over his left eye. Now here is the monster. A lot of folks would call this Frankenstein, but of course it's not Frankenstein. Frankenstein was the crazy scientist. This is Frankenstein's monster, so appropriately named. Sand green used as the skin tone there. A little bit of that is printed onto the torso as well. Nothing to be seen from the back, so he's pretty tattered from the front, but pretty clean cut from around the back. And the big deal here is the add-on headpiece, which is applied like hair, but underneath that you see that it's just a regular minifig head. And it's kind of interesting what they did with the eyes there. Just definitely looks kind of sad, kind of feel sorry for him looking at him like that, but with the brow down kind of makes it look a little bit more angry, I'd say. Now here's the hockey player, comes complete with a hockey stick and a puck, and he also has a set of skates in metallic silver that make him a little bit difficult to pose relative to the others. You can't really stick them to a base with those on, but you can't take those off. This one did get a print to all of his gear on the back. There's no print on the torso underneath of that, front or back, but this is a nice add-on piece, and the helmet is very useful. You could also use that for football as well, American football, that is. And the face mask can be turned up, and you can also remove that to reveal more of his facial expression, which gets meaner and meaner the more of it you see. The street skater here continues the trend of printed accessory pieces with the printed cap there. It's a 2x2 Lego brick that's printed on in lime green with a little bit of kind of drip effects. And then the board itself, the top of that is nicely printed, so that's where that comes from. I only recently learned of the existence of this print, and it's got not only a Lego brick there, but kind of the Brick Masters logo that's printed onto it. And on the opposite end is a skyline. Came with the white colored trolley wheels, or skateboard wheels in this case, which is an interesting piece, and even got a print on the back of the torso this time around. So lots of print with this one. This is actually pretty deluxe, and of course he can ride on that skateboard. And there's a clearer look at the face print. The Sailor, by comparison, is relatively simple with its prints and accessories. Just a telescope piece in medium silver there. Looking around the back, you get just a little bit of print, just a little bit. A little bit of print on the headpiece, but nothing is being hidden in terms of the facial expression. He's got one eye that's closed, kind of looks like he's winking, but that also works out well for lining it up with the telescope. So if you want to make it look like he's looking through that, kind of leaning back like that, and there you go, that's the look. This one is listed as the soccer player, but most of the world would refer to him as the football player. He's got his built-up trophy there with the regular small nano fig piece done in silver. That's on top of a black fez piece, which then has a stud beneath it, just a black stud to allow him to hold onto it. He's wearing shorts, as you can see by the stripe of yellow that goes through there. That's supposed to represent just skin that's showing on the side of the leg. And then this one has a generous amount of print on the back of the torso, not too detailed, but there's plenty there. And he's got a pretty scruffy looking face with some definition lines in it. With the hair removed, he actually looks a little bit happier and more humble with that slightly raised eyebrow. Now here's a werewolf, one of a number of werewolves that Lego would do. And this just adds to the humanoid, you know, horror story subject, little sub-theme that they've got going on in this series. And it's interesting that this series came out the year before they released the Monster Fighters series officially. And this was not like a Halloween release or anything. This was actually a springtime release. So it's really interesting that they threw both of these in there. And there's actually going to be one more to see. I like how they reused the elf hairpiece there and just recolored it. I think they used that to pretty good effect here. Hazmat Guy is another one that really stands out from the line and stands out from pretty much everything else that Lego has done. They've since used that mold for the hazmat suit once again with the helmet and everything, it's with the visor. But this was pretty cool and pretty iconic and also pretty timeless. It's kind of funny that the spray bar there connects to the back of his suit, but I guess they wanted to have some place that it would actually connect up. And with the whole head and body gear piece removed, you can see that there is still some print on the torso to be seen that is hidden most of the time. The Painter is another one that's all about the printed accessories, and this was great for them to introduce both of these, the palette and the paintbrush. They've continued to be used since, and it's just nice to see Lego minifigures having something else to do. You know, stuff that they do is normally limited to vehicles that you put them in, you know, situations you put them in, and the utensils and or weapons that you can put into their hands. You can always do custom stuff, but Lego always does it better and smaller and more succinct and more accurate when they actually mold new things. So this was a great addition to just Lego history in general. So two figures get the exact same skates, the ice skates in this same series. This is the Ice Skater here, gets the medium silver color for the skates and then gets the cloth piece for her dress. that's angled off. It's a unique piece there. The light yellow colored hair, plenty of print around the back, which includes the very shiny metallic print for the little stars there, kind of sequins or jewels of some sort. Looks pretty good. Pretty heavy skin color print down one side of the leg, which does a pretty good job of connecting to the front, but of course there's no print on the back of the legs to really continue that on. But the face here is a real standout, I'd say. And that brings us to the crazy scientist, who is another one that would be used in the Monster Fighter series the next year, although they would change the prints, but they would use the same hair mold that's used here, which is actually a silicone rubber piece. So it's got these points that could be a little bit dangerous, and by putting them in rubber, they just bend and probably a lot more durable that way, will last a lot longer. Transparent bright green used for the beaker there and whatever is inside of that to make it look like it's glowing a bit. Very nice. And with that hairpiece removed, you can see just a little bit more of the face, including the bushy eyebrows, which makes him look even more crazy. And that was it. That's the entire collection of LEGO Series 4 minifigures from 2011. Let me know in a comment which of these is your favorite or which are your favorites. For me, once again, I'm not going to be able to pick out just one as my single favorite because I like so many of them, but I'll give you my top three in no particular order. They are the Hazmat Guy, the Punk Rocker, and the Kimono Girl. So let me know your favorites. I look forward to seeing that. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll talk to you again very soon.